So the next award that we're going to present tonight is the Representative James Leach Award. Put these glasses on it. Thank you, Bart, let me borrow your glasses. Not only can I see out of them, they actually look good, I'm told. But the Representative James Leach Award recognizes the rural nonprofit organization that best promotes fair and equal access to credit and capital and contributes the most in its community toward promoting wealth building in traditionally underserved populations. The winner of the Representative James Leach Award this year, nominated by board member Shelley Sheehy, is Renaissance Rock Island. Renaissance Rock Island. Let's give them a round of applause. So joining me on stage to receive the award, the Representative James Leach Award given to Renaissance Rock Island is Brian Hollenbeck. Brian.
The first word that comes to mind is wow. I'm very humbled. Truly this is a testimony to what can happen when you surround yourself with great people. I have two of those fine individuals with me here this evening, Amy Clark, our Grant Administration Director, and Jill Clark, even though they're not related, over all of our single family and financial education. I don't think it's any strange coincidence that a lot of our success truly has been rooted in our relationship with NCRC. My first event was in 1999, and I can tell you, Mr. Taylor, that a lot of what I've learned here we took back to our community. And as you saw in the the video that was portrayed there is that a lot of those core principles are based on the things that we learn at these conferences. So as you surround yourself with the group of people that you have here and your colleagues, get to know them, listen to what they're doing in their communities, duplicate it in yours, and again, be a part of something bigger than yourself. Thank you so much.
Let's give a big round of applause to Brian and Renaissance. The next award that we'll present is the Senator William Proxmire Award. The Proxmire Award recognizes the individual whose life's work exemplifies the spirit and work of Senator Proxmire's contributions to economic mobility. As we know, Senator Proxmire was the sponsor and sometimes known as the father of the Community Reinvestment Act. So the winner of the Senator William Proxmire Award is Ron Phillips, President and CEO of Coastal Enterprises, Inc. Would Ron come to the stage and let's cue the video.
CDCs actually arose out of the civil rights era in this country.
We were part of an ethos, a culture, of, and a time in American history when we thought change was just right around the corner and imminent.
The CDCs were a way to rally people, the local community, raise capital and invest in the various enterprises in that area. The first CDCs were in African American communities like Bedford-Stuyvesant in Brooklyn, New York. There were Native American CDCs. There were CDCs in Appalachia.
People recognized that there was a need for access to capital, for tools to help them improve their lives. Organizations like OHOPE, organizations like Coastal Enterprise emerged out of that movement.
CI today is constituted with a tremendous set of employees that are accomplished in their own right from previous careers, that have experience ranging from finance to policy to technical areas. For the future, we hope to continue down the path of not only practice doing these projects and making investments, bringing private capital to bear on the change we want to see, but also where there's some scalable impact. That's why the practitioner part of us is important. That's why capital is important, because in the end, although it's insufficient, it makes the difference on whether the fish plant is going to be built or not.
Congratulations, Ryan.
Thank you very much. So the introduction to that video, which we just showed at our annual meeting, our 38th in Brunswick, Maine, actually featured a fish cooperative, a processing cooperative in Booth Bay Harbor, where I was making the point, which was CEI's first major investment, about bringing capital together from different sources to benefit community enterprises. And Maine was looking at fishing as a development area. There are a lot of challenges with the fishing industry in the Northeast and other parts of the world, but that was actually the central message of the film. But as I'm really honored to be here and to be recognized by you all as the heart of the social justice movement, which has defined so much my life and our life at CEI. And all credit is due to the 50 years that we all have together going back to the civil rights era, not only Dr. Martin Luther King, but the challenge of the African-American community, the Native American community, the poor white community. And we put all that together to create the CDC movement, which some of you know about. And in our case, we're a rural CDC, both with a primary market in Maine, but also we've extended it out nationally to other rural communities in partnership with other CDCs and CDFIs, trying to create economic opportunity and connect opportunity to the inequality that is so much evident today, that it's not just opportunity, that it has to be translated to something that's going to deal with the inequality that continues in such dramatic times, dramatic metrics today. And so my view is that when CEI was formed in 1977 as the organizer, and I know this is a lifetime achievement award, but I have not given up yet on many of the things that we're we're doing. I just think that we have to let younger people in, and we've got a great staff at CEI of 85 people, and Laura Buxbaum is here, and we've had several of our staff throughout the period of time that NCRC has grown participate in this end of the equation. But I would say one thing. There are four things, actually. There are four challenges that CDCs that make investments face, in my view, in this country. One is to continue to access flexible capital, both in the form of philanthropy as well as loans from different institutions to do the hard work and heavy lifting we're doing. The second is to make sure that we can be more scalable with those projects and get and access capital markets that are more conventional, like the Federal Home Loan Bank. The third thing is to be able to show impact, and you can see from our numbers, but also from others, that we are making a difference in sustainable community development. But the fourth thing is actually probably the most critical thing, and it's what you all do, it's what NCRC does, and that is policy. And the CRA. Without the Community Reinvestment Act, it's not clear to me that a lot of our work as investors, both nationally and at the grassroots level where we work, would be getting done. Not at all. And so NCRC needs to be persistent, pursue vigilantly not only CRA and its improvement, but also extending CRA type of coverage to other kinds of capital markets. That would be a real huge challenge, and I would really do that. Now the guy, so I thank you very much for this award and this honor, and it's all about all the people and all of you that, and all the work we're doing. I would like to take this opportunity, however, to extend our appreciation to John Taylor, who I think is just the guy to continue on in his next five-year period and expand the CRA to other financial sectors. We have something we'd like to give him. It's a plaque that we're giving to people that and foundations like the Ford Foundation that have contributed so much to the growth of our field. The theme of this is From Civil Rights to Sustainable Solutions. It has a quote from Dr. Martin Luther King when he gave the anti-Vietnam speech at Riverside Church in New York City in 1967. I was there. It was such a magnetic moment. John, where are you?
Thank you, Ron.
It says, in recognition of your dedicated advocacy and support for the community-based economic development movement. Thank you, John.
Thank you, Ron. It's awful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Just don't take my... Thank you, Ron. That is great. That is great. So, first of all, I want to congratulate all of our award recipients. We have a few more items lined up for you tonight, including another surprise video guest, so please turn your attentions once again to the screens.
hello to all my friends at the National Community Reinvestment Coalition. I really, really, really wish I could be with you in person today, but I'm afraid we're just going to have to do this one by video. So first, I want to congratulate NCRC on celebrating your 25th anniversary. Wahoo! This is a special milestone and a chance to look back on the significant work that this great organization has done all during that time to help strengthen our communities. I also want to give a very special thank you to my good friend John Taylor, who has been a terrific partner in a lot of tough fights through the years. John, thank you for your outstanding leadership at NCRC. You are truly an amazing guy. NCRC plays a vital role in pushing for strong, affordable housing goals that will benefit families across the country and help keep homeownership as the centerpiece of the American dream. We are in the midst of an affordable housing crisis, and access to credit for middle and lower income borrowers remains extremely limited, even 8 years after the financial crisis. Whatever our future housing finance system looks like, we need a strong federal commitment to promoting home ownership for lower and middle income families and for families of color. For many of these families, a home isn't just a place to live. It's the college savings plan, the retirement plan, and the foundation for a better life for their children. I know that NCRC fights for this every day, and I just gotta say, I'm proud to stand shoulder to shoulder with you. I said it before, and I'll say it again. Right now, the game is rigged. Washington works great for the billionaires and big corporations who hire armies of lawyers and lobbyists to rig the rules in their favor. But working families, they're getting left behind. So I'm here today to say, we need you. If we're going to level the playing field and give people a fair shot to get ahead, we need every one of you to raise up your voices. To NCRC and all the member organizations that are here today, thank you for all that you do, day in and day out, to build an economy that works not just for some of our families, but for all of our families. Your work really matters. So, congratulations again on 25 years, and here's to the next 25.